Thank you for the introduction and good morning. This research was carried out in collaboration with Gennaro Costagliola, and we are both from Dipartimento di Informatica, University of Salerno, Italy. We will talk about a gesture recognizer suitable for fast prototyping of gesture-based applications. First of all, we will describe the recognizer. Then we will see its evaluation on two different data sets, and then some final remarks. Our recognizer is an evolution of $1 and protractor. Similarly to them, it is scale and optionally rotation invariant, and uses a nearest neighbor approach to classify an input gesture. The similarity between two gestures is calculated through a three-step procedure. Firstly, each gesture is approximated to a polyline. Then the two polylines are aligned to obtain an equal number of segments. And lastly, the distance is found by summing the contribution of each pair of segments. In the preprocessing step, the gesture is reduced to a polyline. Differently from $1 and protractor, our recognizer does not use equally spaced sample points. Instead, we have a reduction of the number of points in two consecutive steps. Douglas Packer, which extracts a small number of dominant points, as we can see in this arrow gesture, we have a polyline of 6 segments. And then a step of line fusion, in which we have a further reduction of the points with small curvature, as the two points on the shaft. The final polyline is only composed of 4 segments. The second step is polyline alignment, in which we obtain a mapping between the points of the two gestures. The objective here is to have the same number of segments in both polylines. The mapping is based on a similarity between the points of the two gestures. To this aim, we use two different features, the position of P, calculated as the length of the gesture up to P, divided by the total length of the gesture. And the second feature is angle of P, which is the change of direction at P, this angle here. The alignment is performed through an adaptation of a string matching algorithm. And details on this are in the paper. Here we have time for an example of alignment. In this example, we have two polylines representing a curly brace, P with 8 points, and Q with 9 points. The endpoints are mapped to each other, and the internal points are mapped by similarity using the features described in the previous slide. As we can see, some points do not have a corresponding similar point in the other gesture. What we do is to sample a new point from the gesture, approximately in the same position of the corresponding one. We add 2 points in P and 1 in Q. In the end, we have 2 polylines of 10 points each. The final step is the calculation of the distance. To this aim, a polyline is represented through a sequence of vectors. The magnitude is the relative length of a segment, and the direction is the slope of the segment in the drawing direction. The vector connecting the endpoints is also considered. To calculate the distance between two gestures, P and Q, we consider the absolute value of the difference of each pair of corresponding vectors in the two gestures. Here is an example vector difference. And the distance also uses a penalty factor which is proportional to the number of mismatches obtained in the alignment step. We can have two different rotation schemas, invariant and sensitive. In the former, the gestures are rotated at zero, and then we have a golden section search. In the latter, they are rotated at the closest of the eight directions. Evaluation, we evaluated the recognizer in a rotation invariant and writer dependent context. We used two different data sets. The first one with 16 different classes, and the second one with 21 classes. And here are the results. The charts show the error rate as a function of the number of templates per class. The red line shows the performance of our recognizer, which was tested with and without the GSS best angle search. The blue line shows the performance of Protractor, to which we compared. And we can see that our recognizer has a clear advantage in terms of recognition accuracy on both data sets. So we got to the conclusion. We presented a unistroke gesture recognizer, which is suitable for fast prototyping due to the possess of some interesting features, such as it is fast, it is accurate, and very simple to use. Last good news, our Java implementation is distributed with an open license on sourceforge.net. Thank you.
So maybe regarding the data sets you used, do you think we need more challenging data sets for these kinds of gesture recognizers, or do these represent the things you would typically want to end with these kinds of recognizers? Because, I mean, the error rates are quite low, so are these suitable to really distinguish the benefits or problems of these recognizers?
I think it should be useful to test the approach on different data sets. These are two data sets which are currently used in tests for this kind of recognizer, but for many others application could be useful to test it on other data sets.